welcome to this YouTube channel initiated by Gnanmanjari Modern School. I hope that you all are very fine with your family members at your houses. Student, right now we are dealing with the poetry section. Last video you have that about MacVittie, very interesting poem that MacVittie was. Now, second poem, poem number second, in the name of the poem is Geography Lesson. So this is also interesting with moral. You have moral in this poem. So let's start this poem. Please keep a book with you so that you can understand this poem very easily. The name of the poem is Geography Lesson. And this is written by Zulfikar Ghosh. This is the poem written by Zulfikar Ghosh and the name of the poem is Geography Lesson. This poem has four stanzas. This poem has been divided into four stanzas and the name of the poem is something like related to social science. But it is very interesting poem and poet wants to convey a good message through his words. Let's see. Can you imagine what your city would look like if you saw it from 10,000 feet above the ground? So here you are asked one question. That question is, what would your city be like if you see or watch your city above from, 10,000 feet above? Neatly planned and perfect in proportion like a geometric design, it would strike you as something very different from what it actually is while you are in the thick of it. See, we see our land and we see our earth from the terrace. So that scene would be different. If we see our earth from that 500 height, that would be different scene. And our the earth scene and picture of or image of earth would be different if we see that earth from 10,000 feet above the ground. So these pictures are different geographically. These pictures are different if we raise our height. So here in this poem, poet just seen that picture of or image of earth through 10,000 feet high. Here is a poet's description of just such a view of the city and some questions that come to his mind. So when poet is watching the earth from 10,000 feet above the ground, at that time he noticed something. And some questions were there in his mind. And what are those questions that is about this poem? Let's start it. When the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had. So here in this stanza, or we can say in this poem, poet is in the jet plane, because here it is given that when the jet sprang into the sky. Sprang means to begin. So our first new word is decay or traveling of sky, he had some question in his mind, and those question is about the geography of the earth. So now he is in the sky in his jet. So he just got that idea that why this city is developed this way and why it was not developed earlier. Means he just got the idea about the geography or town planning or city planning of him. Seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile. So now right now what is he was in 6 inch in mile, means he was not that much in height. That seemed inevitability, that seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard. So inevitability means that cannot be avoided. Means without plan or order. So earlier he had that idea that his plan, his city was not in plan. So now he got that idea, and that cannot be avoided, that how and why this ground about what on ground had looked haphazard, means this plan of the city, how that city is in order and how this city is well planned, that should not be avoided. Why poet just see this city above that height? At that time he got this idea. Unplanned, without style, when the jet sprang into the sky. So that seemed an inevitability about what on ground had looked haphazard, unplanned and without style. Means from that much height, poet has seen that city which is not in plan. Means that city was unplanned. And from above that height, the city was looking unplanned and without sky. Second stanza. When the jet reached 10,000 feet, it was clear why the country had cities where the rivers ran and why the valleys were populated. So in second stanza, poet was there in 10,000 feet height. So at that time he got idea that why rivers are there along with city and why these valleys are, city is populated with valleys, means why valleys were populated, means why valleys were full of flowers, full of minerals, full of some kind of that water and some kind of minerals and all. So from 10 feet high, poet got idea about the construction and town planning of the city. Means river are very important for the city or for the village. So when he was on the earth, at that time he did not have any idea about why rivers are there along with city. But after watching from 10,000 feet, poet got idea that these rivers are very much important for the city, and that's why these rivers are there along with city as well as valley. As we all know that rivers are very important, means rivers water is very important for industry, for that drinking and for all the things. That's why these rivers are there, or rivers are made there for cities. The logic of geography, that land and water attracted men, was clearly delineated when the jet reached 10,000 feet. So those were the questions which poet had in their mind before he went to 10,000 feet above. After that he got idea that water and land both attracted men. Means if men, in human beings found land anywhere. And after that, he found that there is a water near that land. So that attracted most. Means he can establish her industry for that water is needed. So water is the basic need of each and every human being. So that's why poet now got idea about that water and land both attracted men, and that's why it was clearly delimited. Delimited means shown. Delimited clearly means it is clearly shown that river is very useful for people, and that's why river are there near the city area and near village area. So those questions were answered when the poet was there on 10,000 feet high. Now third stanza. When the jet was 6 miles high. Now that jet and poet both just went 6 miles height above. Means above 6 miles after 1,000, it was clear that earth was round and it had more sea than land. So what did he see there? So he just see there, earth was very clear and there was more water, there was more sea than land. Means poet found that number of got when he was on 6 miles above thousands on his day. So these are the new words we have got through this poem, and this information he got about the earth. And by this he just changed his mindset, and he just changed his attitude of seeing earth different way. First he wrote down this, after that we'll go for another information. Still one stanza is needed to discuss. So please you note down these four set of new words. Across cities and to kill. From that fact, it was not clear why. So the moral we got from this last stanza is, but it was clear to understand. Sorry, it was difficult to understand. So poet couldn't understand one thing from that chat. See, what did he notice? He noticed that there are many sea than land. After that, he noticed that city was unplanned. Above there, he noticed. After that, he noticed that rivers and land both attracted men. Means he noticed many valleys, many rivers, and importance of that river. Of importance of that river. So still he couldn't understand one thing, and that one thing is, but it was difficult to understand that the man on the earth found causes to hate each other. So there are lots of causes of hating each other. Means man, people find many reasons to hate each other. Means there is not a single person who just doesn't hate anyone. So how this person can hate anyone that much? Means from above that hate and love and this all kind of disgusting things cannot be seen. So why these people on earth are hating each other without any reason? To build wall across cities, and why these walls are there? Here walls means students' border. Means why this border across the country, this border across the cities, and this border across the states are there? Because at the above, at this that much height, these borders and this hate and this kind of disgusting feelings could not be seen. Means borders are not seen from that much height. So why people indulge themselves in such a thing and to kill? And why people just kill each other for the sake of their selfish purpose? Why people rob other people? Why they kill? Why they murder? And why that people just start hating each other without any reason? Because that kind of disgusting feelings, that hate and this kind of that we can say that evil feelings that cannot be seen through that much height. So why people just hate without reason, and why people build a wall and build a border across the cities and states and nations? From that height it was not clear why. But that from that much height, that wall and border and this feeling of disgust that cannot be seen from the sky. So why people don't understand that this is just ruining themselves, this is not helping themselves? Because the real happiness of the people is just living with peace. Means living peaceful life always gives happiness to each and everyone. That is the moral of this moral of this poem. Means we should not hate each other. We should not compete ourselves with other. We should not just let down anyone. To live a peaceful life means you need to understand this small theory that everybody has their own life, and we should not disturb everybody's freedom. We should not disturb everybody's peace of mind, and we should not disturb their lifestyle. To understand this thing, poet just described this poem to us. Now I give you summary about this poem that will help you to understand this poem more. But before I start, you have few times to note down this thing. If you haven't noticed, please note down. summary of the poem is, the poem displays poet concern for the division and friction among people. The poem begins with the poet seeing the city from the jet. He finds that the cities are not well planned. He realized that water is very essential for various activity such as agriculture, transport, business, etc. As yes. Okay, you first note down this. After that, we go for the student. Please note down this, students. This summary will help you to understand this poem very easily. Let me read it. See, the poem displays the poet's concern for the division and friction among people. So, as you know, then in last stanza we got that idea about the friction of people's mentality, the division in people's mentality. The poem begins with the poet seeing the city from the jet. He finds that the cities are not well planned. He realized that the water is very essential for various activities such as agriculture, transport, business, etc. So, what did he see from the jet? So, he finds that rivers are very important, and another thing he just got is cities are not well planned. So, these are underlined here, underlined. See, cities are not well planned, that he got, and water is very essential for various activities. These two things poet just saw from above. So, you note down this, after that I'll give more. From the same paragraph, as Jet moves higher, he reflects that people have built boundaries and hate each other. So this is the summary of the poem. Now I'll give you the moral, means which moral we get from this poem. So moral of the poem is, we shall use natural resources like land and water wisely, and we shall all live together on harmony and not fight with each other. A beautiful place to live. So this is the moral we got from this poetry. Let me read. The moral of the poem is we should use natural resources like land and water wisely. We should use wisely that we shall all live together on harmony and not fight with each other our over tribal things. Tribal things, very small things. In this way we can make earth a beautiful place to live. So this is the moral we get from the poem, that we should use our natural resources wisely and we should not disturb others' life, and we should not kill anyone, we should not murder anyone, we should not rob anyone's peace, and we should not fight with anyone, or one country should not fight with another country on tribal things, means on small things we should not fight with anyone, and that is the only way to live peaceful life. And if we do these things, our earth would be a beautiful place of living life. So this is the moral, student. Please you note down these. After that I'll give you homework. Please note down. New words, summary and moral of the poem in your book. We will meet again in next video. Till then, bye. Thank you. We'll be right back.